a very, very good achievement on the team's part and something that we really looking forward to build on. Yes, we did not take anything for granted. We knew that, you know, obviously the pitch also got a little slow in the second session, I would say, and the ball, when the kookaburra gets softer, it's more and more difficult for the bowlers to get it, you know, going from length and nick off people. So I think our fast bowlers still came in and bowled with a great heart, but yeah, we knew that they're not going to just throw in the towel like that. Their tail is, I think, in the top three when it comes to lower order averages in the world in the past couple of years. So they put a price on their wicket, and we certainly expected them to fight and put up small partnerships so that they can, you know, keep getting closer to that target. So we had that in mind. We never wanted to take it for granted.
Virat,
among all the positives that you take out from the match, how big is the fact that your fast bowlers could make sustained pressure on them?
Yes, that's a very positive sign, especially I think with the kookaburra, we've not been able to, as you said, sustain that pressure for long enough in the past. But the fact that they're fitter, they're more, you know, they have more pace on the ball now for longer periods, and they understand that their job is at certain times is just to contain. So I think with four bowlers picking up 20 wickets in a test match away from home, especially with a ball that does not offer you so much, is something that we can be proud of. But as I said, we need to build on this. You know, we can't be happy with one test match. And as I said before the series started, that we're not going to be satisfied with one test. Yes, we're happy about this victory, but this is what we need to build on and really capitalize on. So we literally have nothing to lose. We won the last series in India when we played against Australia. We've come out here to have fun, play good cricket, and be positive in our minds. I mean, day one went against us, but the way Pujara brought us back into the game, we did not let up again for 4 days. So I think this time around, we need to learn quicker from our mistakes, and I think we did in this game, and that's why we won.
Yes, sir.
So near, so far,
ये
होता रहा, और आज ये जीत भी ले तो उसका क्या अहम है? और दूसरी बात, अगर आप बोल रहे हो कि ये कंटिन्यू करना है, तो उसके लिए पेशेंस बैट्समैन को सीखना जरूरी है, क्या-क्या आपको?
जी बिल्कुल, पहली इनिंग में जैसे मैंने मेंशन किया कि पहली इनिंग में हम लोगों ने स्मार्ट बैटिंग नहीं करी पहले सेशन में, और उनके बॉलर्स को हमने गेम में आने दिया. बाद में हमको समझ आया कि जितनी देर हम खड़े रहेंगे पिच पे, तो उनको दूसरा तीसरा स्पेल डालना पड़ेगा. उसमें फिर स्कोरिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ ज़्यादा हो जाती हैं. जैसे मैंने बोला, कुकाबरा जब थोड़ा ओल्ड हो जाता है तो आपके शॉट्स और आप लगा सकते हैं. सेकेंड इनिंग्स में डिफरेंट अप्रोच हमें लेनी पड़ी, क्योंकि टाइम था गेम में, तो हम ज़्यादा जल्दी रन बनाने नहीं गए, क्योंकि हमें पता था कि हम अगर उनको फील्ड में रखेंगे तो फ्रस्ट्रेट होंगे, बाद में रन आएंगे. जैसे अजिंक्य ने पॉजिटिव बैटिंग करी सेकेंड इनिंग्स में, पुजारा ने भी अच्छी बैटिंग करी, तो हमारा सिर्फ फोकस पार्टनरशिप्स पे था. आई थिंक फर्स्ट इनिंग्स में हम सब लोग जो टॉप ऑर्डर था, वो काफ़ी मोमेंटम बनाने गए रादर देन गेम को अपने आप अनफोल्ड होने देना. आई थिंक वो एक चीज़ है जो हमें अगले टेस्ट के लिए ध्यान में रखनी होगी. सेकेंड इनिंग्स में हमने बेटर बैटिंग करी इवन ओपनर्स ने, तो हमें उससे काफ़ी सीखने को मिला फर्स्ट इनिंग से. और जैसे आपने बोला कि पहले हम हमेशा बोलते थे कि हमने बहुत अच्छा खेला लेकिन जीते नहीं, तो वो हम वो चीज़ सोचना भी नहीं चाहते कि यू नो कि बहुत अच्छा खेली टीम लेकिन जीत नहीं पाई. हमारा एम सिर्फ जीतने की तरफ है, और अगर अपॉर्चुनिटी होगा तो हम ज़रूर जीतने जाएंगे. हम अपने माइंड में पूरे कन्विंस थे आज सुबह कि दो ही रिजल्ट पॉसिबल हैं, तो हम जीतेंगे या मैच ड्रॉ होगा. हमने हार के बारे में सोचा ही नहीं. तो आई थिंक वो हमें माइंड सेट कंटिन्यू करना होगा आगे के टेस्ट मैचेस में भी. I think you have to figure out for how long two bowlers can bowl together. It depends on how you want to start the session. If Australia's would have been four down for 50, we would have gone with our strike bowler straight away, afford to give a few runs. But the fact that we went with Ishant and Ash this morning was because we wanted to set a template where, you know, they're scoring at 1.5 to 2 runs an over max. And then we build on that, because we didn't want them to gain momentum and, you know, be positive from ball one. And as a batsman, you understand that if you're not playing with positive intent, you can nick off at any stage. And that's exactly what happened. Both those guys, you know, were sort of not ready for, or maybe Travis was not expecting Ishan to suddenly, you know, go short on him. And we just wanted to create that sort of zone where our bowlers are in a good rhythm and they're bowling consistently. And even with second new ball, we gave it to Ash. We thought, you know, he'll get more bite with it. So it's very important to keep an eye on the scoreboard, how many runs, where the game's heading, how the batsmen are playing as well. So I keep looking to improve on that, because in the past there have been sessions where we've given too many runs in one go, and that's something that I as captain have sat down and tried to plug in. And I think in this test match we were pretty balanced in that regard. We never gave away a session where they got away from us. So we'll just have to remember that and make that balance again according to the situation of the game, be more aware. So I think it's awareness that counts most in those situations.
Yeah.
Yes, we necessarily don't, you know, we don't like a school team environment here. Guys, Ishant was the most pissed off right now. We all were very happy celebrating, but he was really, really angry with himself. And I asked him why, and he said, you know, you can't afford to bowl a no ball being a senior guy, having played so many games in a crunch situation when the umpire probably would have given that out. So that could be the difference, you know, at a more important stage in the series. So yeah, I mean, look, guys take ownership of those things. Obviously, you can commit mistakes, but as long as the attitude is right, we look to correct those mistakes. So this incident that's happened, I'm sure Ishant's going to be obsessed about not doing it again. You know, just like how we improved our batting in the second inning straight away, top of the order. Again, guys want to learn as soon as they can, and they are taking responsibility themselves. They're not hiding from it. You know, it's not a case of not wanting to talk about it. They're unhappy themselves that they made that mistake at a crunch situation, and come that situation again, they don't want to do it. So I think that's the most you can ask from any player that's playing for their country, and that's certainly the right attitude to have.
How crucial is that they have sort of found form and runs in the first test of the series, which
look, every batsman every now and then has to work on their game if something's not going right. But you can never take away the player totally. You know, they, as I said in the past so many times, they both technically and temperament-wise, they're both, you know, solid test players. And they've done it before as well, where they batted together. Actually, incidentally, in Bangalore against Australia, when second innings, we needed a big partnership and these two stepped up. So, look, as a captain, you obviously want someone to put their hand up. Pujara was outstanding. He was the difference between the two teams for sure. But I think the way Ajinkya batted, you know, so fearless and positive, and that's his game, that's his template, taking their bowlers on, not being intimidated, you know. He has confidence in his own space, which I think is the most important thing for him. And the fact that he could do it in the first game, and we've seen him build on that in Australia in the past. If he can bat like that in every test match, I think he certainly can take away the game from the opposition in a session. That's how good he is when he's on a roll. So it's definitely a positive sign. Not to forget the way Vijay and Rahul batted as well in the second innings. I think it was overcast in very important phase and they took on the bowlers, especially Rahul. So I think those contributions should not be neglected. A 44-run contribution in context of a 323 target is massive. So I think everyone can be proud of how they played this game. But given an opportunity from 40, get a big 100 in the next game, that's something that every batsman want to do. And that's something that all of us will try and do in the next game. If we have control of the game, drive home the advantage.
One final question.
In the context of the fact that you said the pitch had slowed down, so what was Ashwin given a specific role? How do you think he went today with all the 50 overs in the final innings?
Well, he was given a specific role, yes. I think he was very economical and he bowled in the right areas just to create enough chances and keep one end quiet. Because we didn't want to go overboard, you know, wanting him to attack too much, because that would have opened up scoring options as well. Because actually, if you look at the whole day, they were playing with a mindset where, you know, they knew they're up against it and they were just looking for an opening where you get maybe 50 or 60 runs in an hour and then you start putting the opposition under pressure. So we never wanted that to happen. If this was the case in the first innings where there was that much assistance or these many spots, he would have been more, you know, aggressive with hitting those spots. But the fact that he controlled the game nicely and he kept us in the game, not letting it drift away too much at any stage, I think he did his job perfectly and he finished with, what, 8 wickets in the test? Was it 6 total, 6 in the test. So I think that's a good start for him. I mean, he hasn't started that well in Australia before as well, so I think he can build on that. But he did his role perfectly in the second innings.
Thank you, guys.